சரி சார், நீங்க ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிக்கலாம்.
Good evening all. I welcome every one of you for webinar on insight on data science for engineers by Mr. Vijay Praveen Mahajan. I request our beloved principal Dr. K. A. Muhammad Zunaid to welcome the delegates and present about the college. Principal sir, please sir.
Good evening to one and all joining in this webinar organized by Electronics and Instrumentation Engineering Department of our institution. Our chief guest of today's webinar, Mr. Vijay Praveen Maharaj, business analyst, Siemens, Germany. All the allied participants, faculty members, and students. Really, it's my proud privilege to thank and welcome each and every one of you. On behalf of our respected chairman, sir, members of the management, all the faculty members, and students of our institution, on my own behalf, I wholeheartedly thank and welcome Mr. Vijay Praveen Maharajan for accepting our invitation to conduct this webinar on insights on data science for engineers for the benefit of all the faculty members and students across the country and outside the country. I also welcome all the allied participants who have shown interest by registering themselves and attending this webinar. My dear participants, really, this pandemic period we never ever expected in our lifetime. But to enrich our knowledge during this COVID situation, we have been conducting webinars for the benefit of our own students, faculty members, and also the participants of other college faculty members in and around our country. The eminent resource persons are from various industries and also from academia, including our own alumni who are working across the globe. I would like to share some important information regarding our information institution, including the major achievements of our institution. Our institution established in the year 1995, situated at Kavaipattai, Gumudipudi Taluk, at the distance of 30 kilometers from Chennai. Our college is managed by Lakshmi Kanthamal Educational Trust. We are at the forefront of engineering education, consistently among top 10 engineering colleges across the state. In the year 2019, our graduate percentage is 89.6, and overall result in the year 2019 batch was 93.82. To provide complete education for all our students, there are 200 plus regular recruiters to provide placement opportunity for all the students of our institution who are registered for getting placement. And consistently, they have been maintaining more than 85% annual placement conversion. In the day one campus placement for 2020 batch, totally 816 offers were issued by Cognizant, TCS, Wipro, and Infosys for all the students of RMT Group of Engineering Institutions. Our management team, led by visionary chairman through R.S. Muniratnam, founder chairman, a dynamic personality, a great visionary, and philanthropist, the former member of Tamil Nadu Assembly, elected 3 times in succession. He was instrumental in setting up industrial estate, SIPCOT, and Institute of Road Transport at Gumudipudi. Presently, he is the president of Consortium of Self-Financing Professional Arts and Science Colleges in Tamil Nadu, and is also the chief patron of India Federation of Self-Financing Technical Institutions across the country. He is the honorary advisor for Youth Welfare and Sports Development Department, Government of Tamil Nadu. And for his outstanding achievements in the field of education to the rural community, he has received Vidya Ratna Award. Our management team, consisting of our respected chairperson, Madam Thirumal Manjula Muniratnam, and beloved director, sir, through R. Jolly Naidu, our respected vice chairman, sir, through R. M. Kishore, our respected secretary, sir, L. M. Pradeep, and our vice chairperson, madam, Dr. Durga Devi Pradeep, and trustee, madam, Srimati Soumya Kishore. Our institution first approval received in the 1995. We are in the 25th year of Excellence in Technical Education, approved by AICTE, New Delhi, and affiliated to Anna University, Chennai. All the UG programs of our institution are accredited by National Board of Accreditation, New Delhi. And we have got A+ accreditation by NAC, and accredited by Tata Consultancy Services with B grade. And there are 7 UG programs and 3 PG programs. Total intake of 3,228 with 219 faculty members, and maintaining faculty student ratio of 1:15 with 61 faculty members with PhD. We have 7 UG programs: civil engineering, computer science and engineering, electrical and electronics engineering, electronics and communication engineering, electronics and instrumentation engineering, mechanical engineering, information, BTech information technology. We have also applied for getting autonomous status from Anna University and UGC for the academic year 2021, and it is under process. And we have planned to start BTech Artificial Intelligence and Data Science and BTech Computer Science and Business Systems, subjected to approval by AICTE and Anna University, completely powered by industries like Tata Consultancy Services and Cognizant. And we have 3 PG programs: Applied Electronics, Computer Science and Engineering, and Power Electronics and Drives. And our 6 departments are recognized research center to pursue PhD by the faculty members of our institution and other institutions. The departments of CSE, EEE, ECE, Physics, Chemistry, and Maths. There are more than 150 faculty members are pursuing their PhD. With respect to achievements and recognitions, in the year 2008, we have received best overall performance by ISTE New Delhi. In the NARF ranking, we have been maintaining top 100 and 200 positions for the past 3 years. In the recently announced NARF ranking 2020, our position is 155 out of 200 ranks given by MHRD, Government of India. And with respect to cleanliness, hygiene, maintenance inside the campus, we have received 6th rank in the Swachhta ranking across the country by MHRD, Government of India. In the AICTE-CII survey of Best Industry-Linked Institute, our electronics department received the award in the year 2015, CSE and IT in the year 2018, and mechanical in the year 2019. So from the inception, there are 955 university rank holders, including 23 gold medals, and graduate percentage is 96.11. With respect to Industry Connect, we have a very strong relationship with all the industries, including core companies, and we have established 14 Center of Excellence laboratories in the latest technology areas in collaboration with the industries. NAC has approved our institution to mentor 10 institutions to get 10 institutions to get NAC accreditation. We have also received Best Institutional Food Safety Award from Government of Tamil Nadu. We have also organized TEDx during the year 2019. And in the year 2018, our institution is identified by MHRD, Government of India, and AICTE to host Smart India Hackathon 2018, one among the 28 model centers across the country. So during the validity function, Honorable Minister of State for Housing and Urban Affairs, Sri Hardeep Singh Puri, participated and presented the winners' prizes to all the winners during this 36 hours of continuous hackathon. And our students are also participating in Smart India Hackathon competition, continuously getting prizes. 2 teams won prize in the software edition 2018, and totally 3 teams, 2 in software and 1 team in hardware, received prizes in the 2019 Smart India Hackathon. The AICT Chapter Vishwakarma Award, our ENA students received the 3rd prize in the national level, and prize given by the Honorable Vice President of India. Under Unnat Bharat Abhiyan MHRD scheme, we have adopted 5 villages in and around our institution. And MHRD's innovation cell, we are provided with 4-star rating. We have also MSME incubator and e-cell approved by Government of Tamil Nadu. All the leading magazines ranked our institution in the top 10, top 50, and top 100 positions in the year 2019 and 20. With respect to research and development, industry consultancy, publications by faculty members, and awards received by our students, total research project worth of 10.52 crores so far the inception, and consultancy amount received is 1.14 crores. And totally 1,348 papers, research papers published by our faculty members in the referee journals and international journals in the past 3 years. Our students continuously getting best student and best project awards from the professional societies like ISTE, IE, IETE, CSI, TCS, and Cognizant, and other reputed institutions. our students also won the Cognizant's Big Idea Contest. In collaboration with industries, the COE Laboratories established for the benefit of all the students to provide business unit hiring opportunity for the students. With respect to COE Laboratories established in our institution, which includes the areas like artificial intelligence, cyber security, big data analytics, cloud computing, front-end engineering, and Microsoft Dynamics. We have also established COE Laboratories in the areas of telecom, embedded systems in collaboration with Wipro, automotive electronics in collaboration with KPIT, and factory automation completely sponsored by Mitsubishi Electric India, and building management system in collaboration with JCI Pune. And PLM Automotive R&D and complete farmout COE Laboratories were also established in our institution in collaboration with the industries. And with respect to the training provided for our students to enhance their knowledge and skills to get placement during their final year, we have 360-degree structured training program from first year to final year. 600+ hours of training provided to all the students of our institution. So that we have been maintaining more than 85% every year. For the 2020 batch, the placement percentage was 88%. And our students are also getting higher salary package offers from the companies. For example, two students have received 28 lakhs offer, and one student received 17 lakhs offer, and two students received 14 lakhs per annum offer from Amazon from the 2020 batch. So with respect to alumni association activities, our alumni, they are always interacting with our institution and the students. And recently, our chairman last year visited USA to inaugurate USA Alumni Chapter, conducted USA Alumni Meet in 5 different places at USA. And around 500 alumni have participated along with their family members to grace the alumni inaugural function at USA. With respect to infrastructure and facilities, we have ESEL, MSME Incubator, and RMK student startup programs for the benefit of all the students who are interested to become entrepreneurs. To provide opportunities and to develop their entrepreneurial skills, these cells are utilized by the students, and they are arranging programs for the benefit of all the students. Every year, there are 5 to 10% of students who are becoming entrepreneurs. The recent past 3 years, the number of startups by our own students is 23. And the Center for Higher Education provides opportunity for the students to get into reputed institutions for higher studies in India and abroad. Every year, 15 to 20% of students are joining in reputed institutions. And Center for Foreign Languages, we offer Japanese language training program for the students. Last year, more than 50 offers by Japanese companies with a salary of 24 lakhs yen per annum. And Center for IPR and Patents encourage the students and conduct the programs for the benefit of students and faculty members to convert project into patent. So far, 23 patents have been filed, and out of which 15 patents are published. We have Center for Online Learning to encourage the students to take up NPTEL and Coursera online certification programs. And Center for Faculty Development have a strong computing facility with 1,080 computers, including latest configuration system and internet bandwidth. Campus is enabled by Wi-Fi. And library, full stack library with nearly 1 lakh books and 26,809 titles, digital library and health center with a full-time doctor. We are operating buses from all major routes from all major parts of the city by covering all the places in and around Chennai. And also with respect to sports facilities, we are encouraging the students to participate in all the events in the state level, national level, and also in the international level. We have a hostel facilities for our students, boys hostel 3 blocks, girls hostel 3 blocks, and we have AC gymnasium in both the hostels, Wi-Fi facility, and recreational facilities for our students. And general amenities, which include parents' waiting hall, exclusive dining hall, and also to provide purified drinking water. RO plant is also situated in our institution. Bank, ATM facility, post box facility, and to provide uninterruptible power supply. A power generator with the capacity of more than 1,000 kVA is available. And we have a effluent treatment plant for getting water for gardening purpose. And also safety measures are also being established in our institution by the management. And our group of institutions consists of 8 institutions, including 4 schools, 3 engineering colleges, RMK Engineering College, RMB Engineering College, RMK College of Engineering and Technology, and Polytechnic, Durga Devi Polytechnic College. And 4 schools, RMK Matriculation School, RMK Residential Senior Residential Senior Secondary School and RMK Patasala, situated at Kavaripetti. There are one more school at Tiruvekkadu near Chennai, RMK Senior Secondary School. I would like to once again thank all the elite participants and the eminent resource person, Mr. Vijay Praveen, for providing this opportunity for our institution to conduct this webinar by E&A department. I also thank our E&A HOD and all the faculty members of E&A department for taking very sincere efforts and also making all the arrangements for conducting this webinar. And I also thank the technical in charge to provide video streaming and also other technical facilities for hosting this webinar, Mr. Arthanarishwaran from Computer Center. For further details, please visit our website www.rmkec.ac.in. Thank you one and all present.
Thank you, Principal Sir, for giving a wonderful speech and a nice presentation. Let me share my screen. I want to share my screen. I want to give a small introduction about our department. So once again, I welcome every participants for a live webinar session by Mr. Vijay Praveen Mahajan. He is basically an electronics instrumentation engineer, shifted as a data scientist on insight on data science for engineers. About our department, the department started in 1998. It is a 22 years old department. We have all the basic infrastructure and facilities. It is placed in a green and clean campus. Our students are doing excellence in academic. As on date, we tagged 112 university ranks, and our success rate is 95% for the last 3 years. In 2015-19 batch secured 10 university ranks, which include one university second rank, which is the highest number of university rank in the affiliated department, the Anna University. One of the major strengths is our faculty team. We have 12 regular faculty members, in which 3 faculties are PhD and 7 faculties are doing PhD. 3 professors, all are recognized supervisors of Anna University, and they are guiding the PhDs. And next thing is our department is linked with the industry strongly. We have a strong linked relationship with the industry. So that's why we are awarded the best industry linked institute by the ASDCA survey in 2015. And we maintain the platinum category. We also doing the projects. As of now, we received 21 lakhs sanctioned under AICT. AKA scheme and DST projects. Our faculty is also doing consultancy services to various industries. We received 21 lakhs as of now. We also have this strong publication, both faculty and the students. We published Web of Science and Scopus ACE indexed journals of 48 numbers in the last 2 years. We filed patents 5 numbers. One is in under examination, published 2, filed 2. We have startups. We have 7 startups along with our students, which are attached to the RMK Incubation Center. Our student and faculty received many awards. Some of the awards: IEI Best Student Award, IEI Best Faculty Advisor Award, IST Best Student Award 2017 and 19, Best Mentor Award, Cognizant Best Faculty Award. Our students are doing excellence in placement. Last 3 years, average placement is more than 90%. The current batch placement is 98%. Out of 50% of the students placed in 4 companies. The major recruiters are Johnson Control, Soliton Technology, Honeywell, KPD Technology, Wipro Embedded, HCL. And IT and ITS companies like Tata Consultancy Service, Infosys, Cognizant, Wipro, and the Zogo Corporation. We established a Center of Excellence Laboratory to conduct the value-added course The aim of the conducting the value-added course is to increase the employability of the our student and reduce the gap between the industry and the institution. Under the COE lab, first we established a factory automation lab, which was established in 2015, and it is fully sponsored by Mitsubishi Electric Private Limited, and they sponsored equipment worth of 31,56,000, and the Mitsubishi is again ready to sponsor the SCADA package worth of 5,91,000 in coming years. So next laboratory is the Building Management System Laboratory, which is technically collaborated with Johnson Control India Private Limited, and it was established in 2016. The equipment worth of 5,16,000 is sponsored by management. The Johnson Control every year conduct the Johnson Enrich program, and the selected students get the full-time intern and as well as the placement. Another lab is the Embedded System and Robotics Lab, which is connected with the Yendra Lab setup initiatives. It is sponsored by IIT Bombay and is funded by the MHRD. It was inaugurated in 2018. We have equipment worth of 2,60,000, which is sponsored by management. We have the LabVIEW Academy inaugurated in 2019. We received the Best LabVIEW Academy Award also. Our students are participating in extracurricular and co-curricular activities. I mentioned some of the activities and awards. Our students participated in Odisha Hackathon in 2018 and won the first prize under the other state category and the theme of ecology and environment for the project of smart class scan management system. They received a cash prize of 93,750. The management also gave the same amount and in addition to the travel expenses to encourage our student. Our students won the Chatra Vishwakarma Award in 2019 for the project of smart waste management system using IoT. And 2018 Smart India Hackathon Software Edition, one of our team won the first prize, 1 lakh, for the problem of battery monitoring system, which is given by Mahindra Electric Private Limited, and management also provided 1 lakh rupees along with the travel expenses to motivate our students. Our students also participated in Yantra competitions, a team participation in regional final robotics idea competition, and won the prizes of rupees 5,000 and a drone. Another team participated in the robotic competition, which was held at the Anna University, and won the first place. We have two kind of scenario. We always do the focused student activities in terms of the value-added courses, which increase the employability, and we inculcate the innovation and R&D, and we encourage the student to the online courses like NPTEL. And our RMK Engineering College also sponsors Coursera and Udemy and SoloLearn. We have an interaction with industry in terms of industrial visit guest lecture internship. And apart from that, separate training and placement, taking care of the placement training, we have 576 hours of training. And in addition to that, daily students are taking SkillRack MCQ coding test. And all the corporate contests, our students are participating, won the many prizes. And because of this value-added course and structured training program, our alumnus are occupying the corporate civil services, manufacturing, automobile, even in services. Our alumnus are the proud ambassadors of ours. We can follow us. We have a social media network of Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram. And with this, my small presentation over. Now I want to introduce our today's chief guest, Mr. Vijay. Mr. Vijay, about education, Mr. Vijay has received a bachelor's degree of Electronics and Instrumentation Engineering in 2013 from Anna University. He received his master's degree in electrical engineering with a specialization of communication in 2015 from Technical University of Munich. And about his work experience, he has started his career as a data scientist, computer customer intelligence, telephone gun, Moody's Germany during 2014 to 2018. He started his another career as data visualization expert and interim project management in the Volkswagen AG, Wolfsburg, Germany. Currently, he is working as a customer analytics solution expert, business analyst, Siemens Munich, Germany. He is residing in Germany. And his recognitions and awards are, he is a TEDx speaker, first Indian to be invited for a TEDx talk in Germany. Awarded as 40, data scientist under 40. And he got this award in when he is 29 years old. It's by the Analytics India magazine. He is nominated as a top 20 inspiring data scientists to be followed 2020 by AI Time Journal from the United States. He is a very good content creator. Around 30,000 people are following him on LinkedIn. I am also one of his followers. Because of that, today he is the chief guest for this function. With this, I thank you. Now, over to Mr. Vijay Praveen Magajan. Have a great session, Vijay.
Yeah. Thanks a lot, sir. It's been a pleasure to host a webinar for the academicians, industrial experts, students, PhD scholars. So, hello guys, thanks a lot for joining us today. It's been, a lot of participants have already joined in Zoom, and I just noticed the YouTube video link, and close to 250 people are watching it online. So thanks a lot guys. So before we start, let's get into some fun. So I would request you guys to take your mobile phones or internet, just go to your browser and click on slido.com. So it is as simple as that. So we'll have some fun before we start. It's not that complicated. So don't worry, it's not that complicated. If you have a mobile browser, just go to slido.com. And all you have to do is type in the code 31434. So the code that you see on the screen, 31434. Just go to slido.com and there will be a question for you. Where are you joining us from today? So if you are joining from Chennai, please write Chennai. If you are joining from Nagpur, Mumbai, because I just read the comments on YouTube section and I'm actually pleasantly surprised to see that there are a lot of participants joining across India and across the globe, in fact. So let us see where are the people joining us from. And if you are joining from Coimbatore, it is no more CBE, it is KPT. on a lighter note, because we had a lot of city names renamed in Tamil Nadu. So for the guys in Tamil Nadu, they'll understand this humor. So shall we have the results? And I also read that there are some audio issues with the Zoom call when Principal Sir and HOD Sir were talking. Is it better now? Can anybody help me drop a note?
Your audio is very much clear.
Okay, perfect. So yeah, you can always use the chat window below. I am following the chat both on Zoom as well as on YouTube. I mean, there is a big technical support team which is helping me out. So before I start the session, I would like to do this little session. Oh my God. I got like 130 votes. Let's see where people are from. So I would request some of the technical team to take a picture of it so that you get an idea where people are from. So people are from Kanpur, Velur, but now it is Velur. Thanks a lot. NMIMS, thanks a lot, guys. They are from Bengaluru, West Bengal, Rajasthan, People are from RMK, Oman, Salem, Tamil Nadu, Mumbai, Sivagangai, Tamil Nadu, Mayiladuthurai. People are from WhatsApp. Cool. Saudi Arabia. Oh, that's nice. Ponneri. Cool. Okay, so we'll just go on to the next question. What would you like to learn today? Like, it can be anything. Just open it up. I mean, you can be a beginner, you can be an intermediate, you can be a pro. I mean, I consider myself as an intermediate, even though I'm working on this field for years now. It's always good to learn something new every day, right? So that is what we should follow. So what would you like to learn today? It can be anything. It can be data science. It can be about TEDx journey. It can be about RMK, for instance. I mean, the principal sir and HOD sir, they get a crisp and clear picture of what they are. So if you are interested in joining them, please go ahead. So this is again just to get a clarity on what is it. So again, for guys who joined late, please go to slido.com, enter the code 31434, and you will get a question, what would you like to learn today? Okay, I'm getting close to 75 votes. If I touch 100, I'll display the result. So the question is about data science, guys. So you cannot simply expect something which is totally irrelevant, but nevertheless, we'll see what the results are. So guys are keeping them coming. I mean, I already got 115 answers. Okay, let me display it. Okay, so people want to learn about data science concepts, data analytics, data science, information to master in a data scientist, okay, real-time application. Again, I would like to ask the technical team to make a screenshot of this just for your records. How did you transform into data scientist from a non-CS branch? That's perfect. I would like to touch upon this particular question here. Basics, fun in data science. Cool. Skill needed for a fresher. Okay, cool. That's actually good. Okay. Okay, perfect. I got a lot. Luckily, most of them are relevant to data science. Happy on that note. Okay, guys, and just we'll go into the last question and then we'll get into the session. I mean, you guys have been waiting for a long now. So, on a scale of 1 to 10, how are you feeling today? I mean, I know that you are hardly hit by the COVID times. Even I'm working from home for the past 3 to 4 months. But just let me know, how are you feeling today? If you are really good, go for 10. If you are okay, go for something like 5. It's just for fun, guys. So just to see what level of mood my audience are in currently. Okay, cool. Okay, so most of the audience are luckily on the other half of the good side. I mean, the good side, they are on the good side. Okay, cool. Thanks a lot, guys. I mean, you should do the same for Indian elections as well. Each and every vote counts. So, okay. Thanks a lot. Let us go to the session. I already got 150 plus votes. Thanks a lot for the immense response. Okay. So, do you guys see the presentation slides? Can someone help me? Do you guys see the presentation slides or?
Yes, sir. Stop the screen.
Okay, so just a second. So you see the full slide, right? Hello, sir.
Yes, sir. You can see the slide.
Okay.
Join it the same slide.
Yeah, I mean the poster that is prepared by you. Okay.
No, Vijay, it is showing the join at slido.com.
Okay. Just a second.
Vijay, stop the screen.
Yeah.
Now you start again the presentation.
Share the presentation screen.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah, right.
Now it is right.
Okay, perfect. So, guys, first of all, I would like to thank the principal, sir, Mohammad Junaid, and the HOD, sir, Dr. Yanasekaran, sir, and also the entire fraternity of E&I team, and also the technical team for inviting me to host this webinar. So it's been a pleasure to host a webinar virtually because of this COVID times, and times are getting tough, and it's good to see colleges quickly adapting to the nature of what we are. So I mean, like we are hardly hit by this COVID. So first of all, I would also like to advise you to stay safe and healthy, because that is really important at the moment. And upskilling, there is always such webinars and events hosted by RMK. You can always go to their YouTube channel or contact any of their faculties to get noticed about the upcoming webinars. So thanks a lot for inviting me, and it was indeed a great pleasure, to be honest. So yesterday I was having a chat with the principal, sir, and HOD, sir, as well. So for sure, I'll be also visiting the campus because I'm really excited about the achievements. And
so thanks a lot for inviting me, and
I'm getting a noise in the background. Yeah. So first up, before getting into the session, I would like to introduce myself. HOD sir and principal sir have already introduced myself to a great extent, but nevertheless, I would like to touch upon a little bit. So as HOD sir told, I'm a TEDx speaker. I did my master's in electronics in Munich. So for the guys who are wondering, what is this guy from an instrumentation background, from an electronics background, is doing in data science? So again, this is one of the questions that I got on the chat or on the slido.com today. So I would also like to touch upon this journey. So for that, it will be inspiring for a lot of guys like me who study non-CS background. I mean, it is a myth that only CS people or coding guys can be able to perform well in data science. It is not exactly the true moment. I mean, look at me. I'm from instrumentation engineer. I'm an instrumentation engineer by background, and I'm actually doing quite well in data science at the moment. As you can see, the awards. Have bagged a couple of awards this year. Even though 2020 is treating a lot of others awfully, it's been kind to me so far by giving me a lot of opportunities, and in a way I'm getting myself involved. So for guys who want to also follow me, that's my LinkedIn name and LinkedIn profile. You can always go there and follow me. So when it comes to profession, I'm pretty serious. So you can always get a lot of posts from me on LinkedIn. And if you also wish to follow me on other platforms, you can always go to my website, which is listed below. So there you can find me on all other platforms. So thanks a lot again. We'll go into the session. So data science is everywhere, right? People are talking about it everywhere. So It's in retail industry, it's in pharmaceutical, it's in automotive, it's in mobility. It is everywhere. Data science has been implemented, has been used in almost all the facets of life. So that is why we are here to learn something about data science today. So before I start, I always do this in webinars. I mean, like, I'm not sure if there are people who already have listened to my webinar in the past. So I conduct webinars on a regular basis, especially during this COVID times. So I always do this at the start. What are all the real world, real time data science applications that you know? Let's make it interactive. So I'll be following the chat window on Zoom platform as well as on YouTube. I'm sure that there are a lot of people watching. I mean, I could see that from the odds. So what are all the real world applications in data science? So I'll give you a minute just to think about it. Real world applications in the sense, what you use every day, which apps, which mobile apps has data science on it. What are all the data science applications? So is there any text on Zoom or LinkedIn? Yes, there are a couple of answers coming on YouTube already. So that is LinkedIn. Yes, LinkedIn uses a lot of, I'm getting an answer. Yeah, R, Tableau, Python. Yeah, I mean, real world applications. Let me give you an example just to make your life a lot easier. So I'm pretty sure that most of you have a Facebook account. So Facebook uses data science as a part of it. So how many of you are aware of this friends suggestion list? So if you are a friend of mine, then probably you will get a friend suggestion from my list of friends. That is actually a data science product. So any other applications like friend suggestion lists on Facebook? Anything, it can be anything. Yeah, I'm getting a lot of text now. I guess YouTube is like actually a fraction of second lag. I mean, it has a lag. So I'm getting answers now. Yes, Satish is right. Recommendation engines. That is a perfect example. So the recommendation engines that you see on YouTube, that is a perfect example for data science. So how many of you listen to A.R. Rahman song and you get his songs in a loop, right? That is actually a data science algorithm. I mean, it doesn't simply, YouTube isn't some superpower which throws out a similar taste of songs to you. That is a data science product. That is a data science application. And talking about recommendations, Flipkart is a nice example. Amazon is a beautiful example. I mean, if you order a keyboard, then you will get a suggestion list of mouse. So those are not the guys from marketing. Those are data scientists behind those recommendation engines. Exactly, I got answers from Karthik says Netflix, that's amazing. Again, in the recommendation engine. Srinivas Vimal says Amazon. Jayalalita says internet search. Yeah, to an extent, data science has greatly influenced the internet searches of late. That is true. And hospital data sets, Pradeep. Yes, Pradeep, thanks a lot. It is true. We have this modern applications like Fitbit and a lot of data science medical applications. I mean, there are a lot of fitness apps. So gym applications, workout applications, and Karthik says weather prediction. That is true again, weather prediction and natural calamities prediction like tsunami prediction or earthquake warnings. So yeah, you guys are amazing guys. So yeah, it is used on a lot of areas. So for guys who want more answers or want to see the real world applications, please log on to YouTube because guys are actually bombarding the chat box with a lot of informative answers, and most of them are true. I mean, I have gone through a quick brief and I could see a lot of it. So speech recognition, shopping sites, railways, yes. Perfect, guys. So why is this sudden buzz? I mean, what happened to a lot of industries because of this data science? What happened? So since 2000, I mean, half of Fortune 500 companies are pushed out of the business because of this digitalization. I mean, not especially because of digitalization. It is more exactly with relevance to artificial intelligence, machine learning, and data science. I mean, if you are from a city like Chennai, you are aware of this call taxi. I mean, fast track call taxi, right? So where are they now? They are there almost extinct. I mean, right now, there are a lot of automotive firms and apps like Ola, Uber. So they use a lot of data science applications. So if you book a car in Ola or Uber, the pricing depends on a lot of factors. That is again a data science product. So it takes where you want to go. Let's say if you want to go to airport, there will be a pricing, and it considers the time, the frequent usage from the user, gender of a user. So there are a lot of factors being considered. So when the industries or when the digital disruption is there, you need to adapt yourself. So and I'm not blaming Fast Track here, but that is the case. I mean, like a decade back, there were a lot of fast tracks going around cities like Chennai and other metropolitan cities as well. So you have those models. And how many of you, I mean, 90s kids will remember this Kotak camera. So we used to use that Kotak camera, and there will be a roll. There is a negative that we need to develop into a picture. But what happened to them now? That is because of the digitalization. I mean, the artificial intelligence nowadays, people just use just a click. They upload it on Instagram, Snapchat, and you get this face recognition as someone told in the chat window. There is this face recognition. I mean, how many of you have noticed your galleries? It recognizes your faces and it clusters photos accordingly. You can save it under any names. I mean, your mom, dad, friends, whatever it is, it recognizes the photo's face and it clusters together, right? That is again a data science product. So that is why I say artificial intelligence and data science is actually a way more disruptive than we thought. So in my opinion, the coming years will be, I mean, of course, there will be a lot of automations, there will be a lot of jobs will be offered, and the jobs will also be lost in some cases. I mean, when things get automated, it is also affect the job market, right? So yes, that is again true. Okay, so I'm a fresher, I'm intermediate, or I'm somebody new to data science. So what level are you in? I mean, let's also pose this question here just to make a little pass again, just to see, because we got a lot of time here. So what level are you in data science? Are you a beginner? Are you an intermediate? Or are you a master? Or even advanced level? Just giving it a pass, again, giving a minute. So just to see what range of audience I have got. And yeah, got an interesting answer set. Yeah, Aditya Venkat Ramani said COVID peak prediction. That is also true, right? We forgot a lot of COVID maps. Okay. Sharmila says data is the new oil, quote by Ambani. It is actually quote, not exactly from Ambani. Probably he might have said it somewhere, but it is said long back. Yeah. Okay. Any answers coming? A lot of beginners. Ravi Mohan is intermediate. Anurag Gupta has not yet started. That is not at all a problem. That is why we are here. Suresh Kumar is at zero level. Perfect, bro. Perfect. That is perfect. Because when I started, I bet you can also do it like me. I mean, I did the hard way. I was an instrumentation engineer with knowledge about sensors, actuators, electronics, devices, and connections. But 10 years, I mean, 8 years later, you see me as a data scientist and doing some good things in data science world. So, yeah. And Govind Kumar says, voice is not clear. Some network problem could be. Yeah, probably some network issues with your end. I mean, if there is a net.
Your voice is very much audible.
Okay, perfect. My voice is actually clear from my end. If there is an issue, the technical team will take care of it. But nevertheless, you can always close the window and reopen the link again so that you get a better connection. And Nagendra KG is an intermediate to expert. Congratulations. Cool. Okay, so most of the chats I have personally gone through are beginners and intermediates. So this is just to gauge the audience, just for me to analyze at what level are you in so that I can structureize the contents in a way. Okay, so I'm sure that after the session, you guys will go on to Google and type in what is data science. And this is what you will get. So you will get a lot of softwares or keywords that our little brother Google will always help us out. But yeah, as experts always say, I mean, never touch Google when you are sick. Because even with the little headache, Google tells that you might have a cancer. That is true in data science as well. So if you go on to Google, it will throw a lot of contents relevant to Jupyter notebooks, relevant to R, Pandas, Matplotlib, Python, so many stuff. So what should I do? I'm a beginner. I'm at a zero level, as a lot of people said in the chat box. So what should I do to reach? I mean, you cannot simply go and reach 100. As I said, even I consider myself as somebody with 70 or 80 with all these years of experience. So even from 0 to 50, how should I go? I try to Google what is data science, and I see a lot of keywords on it. So what should be done? So for the programmers, I would suggest you can either go with Python or R language. Or it's a language, it's a programming language. I'm sure that a lot of intermediate guys and expert guys are very well aware of this particular tool. And yeah, for those who want to grab the data from the databases, SQL is pretty important. And for data visualization, you need tools like Tableau. I just want to be clear here, I'm not here to market any tools, as I haven't created any of these tools, or I'm not here to market any of the tools that Siemens produces. So these are pretty much open sources. I mean, Tableau is a paid version, but for a guy who wants to jump into data science, I would strictly advise you to start with Python. Go to Google, type in Python, you will get tons of contents. I mean, I'm not a big fan of learning with a lot of huge investment. I mean, if you are learning it from proper recognized institutions like RMK or other engineering colleges, it is well and good. But there are a lot of private organizations that is hosting a lot of fancy courses in the name of data science. I'm pretty skeptical about it. In a way, I recommend you to learn by yourself. So Python or R, this is a go-to option. Okay, so let's have another little pass. How many of you are non-programmers? Because I'm pretty sure that there are a lot of faculty members For them, I mean, I would say programming is in their day-to-day life. I mean, they need to teach stuff to us. So program, faculty members, managerial positions, leaders, market leaders, and a lot of other guys. So how many of you are non-programmers or non-coders? Trust me, I'm on your list. I was on your list. I started from instrumentation, so even I was blank at the beginning. Thanks a lot, Pulipatti Swaroop. He already said it's a nice session. the session has just started, Swaroop. Bhaskar Kapoor is again saying, okay. Okay. And for guys who are asking for feedback forms, you will get that at the end, or the technical team will reach out to you. So once you complete the feedback form, you will get an e-certification from the RMK and the team. Yeah, non-programmer, Ravi Mohan, Raj Mohan, Jai Shri, Brahmananda, Hari Kumar, Verma. So yeah, there are quite a lot of non-programmers and a mix of programmers as well. I mean, nowadays, in this current digital era, being a coder makes a lot of sense. But again, I get a lot of texts from non-programmers. So what should they do? Just a second. Yeah. So what should they do as a non-programmer? How do they learn data science and the stuff? So this is for you guys. I mean, there is a way for you to get into data science, work around the data sets, and to produce real world applications like what I said. So there are tools like RapidMiner, DataRobot, NIME, IBM Watson Studio. I've said this in the previous webinars, which I have hosted as well. So I have personally used NIME, K-N-I-M-E, which is at the third box. So some of you can take a screenshot of it. Maybe you can use it later on at the end of the session. I am pretty sure that these softwares have a trial period, let's say a 14-day period or a month period, which is actually helpful for a lot of beginners and non-programmers. I mean, I'm pretty sure that it requires a little bit of programming, but at the end of the day, most of the things will be drag and drop. So yes, these are the tools for the non-programmers to make a note of. So again, coming back to those who are still not clear about data science, I mean, the name has it. As the name suggests, just a second, I'm getting a lot of texts. I'll answer it in a while, guys. I'm concentrating on the session. Yeah. As I said, I would like to structurize everything into three things here. Data science. We have the data sets. As he said, I'll walk you through the real world examples that we did. So when I started with a company called Telefonica, what we did is we were a telecom company like Airtel, Jio, Aircel. So what we did is here in Germany, most of the people use postpaid SIM card. So unlike Indians, we don't prefer prepaids here. It is all about postpaid. So what we predicted which customers will go for their next SIM card. So let's say I am a customer of Telefonica. I already have a SIM card. And what is the factor which pushes me to go for a next SIM card? So we got a lot of interesting results. I mean, getting married, relocating to a new place, or child status. So they'll obviously buy a SIM card for the next, child that grows over 10 or 12, right? I mean, that is the average age which a kid uses mobile phone here in Germany, unlike the case in India. So yeah, data science is similar. I mean, we can build a lot of products. I mean, how many of you heard of Euro Championship? I mean, Euro Cup, which is a football tournament, which is really famous in Germany and across the globe. So what we did is we predicted which areas will have a lot of viewership. So we targeted personalized advertisements. So for instance, if there are a lot of Spanish settlements in a city in Germany, then obviously they will watch Spain matches a lot. So we gave personalized recommendations to those people. I mean, if you click this or if you go to this link, you get 10 gigabytes of internet. So that is what data science can do. It can penetrate the market and it can produce what we actually need. I mean, what the market needs. And then another important feature is visualization. I mean, okay, you have collected a lot of data sets. You have done a lot of algorithms. You are trying to build a product. What should we do? Then there should be a visualization, right? So visualization in the sense, starting from bar graph, pie chart, Gantt chart, a lot. There are a lot of visualization techniques across. I mean, you can always Google that. So visualization is also one of the important factors. And then comes the narration part. So not many succeed here. I mean, I have seen guys who code like anything. I mean, they'll jump into the code. They'll be the master of that particular algorithm. But they lack this narration skills. I mean, it is always better to have a linked proper story for any product. And particularly in data science, you need that narration skill. So start talking. I mean, it can even take you to public speaking level. I mean, I have got this TEDx opportunity just by talking. So have in mind that you need narration skills. So yeah, a guy from instrumentation engineering doing data science and also doing this public speaking, it is all because of this proper mix of these three skills. So again, we'll just make a little pass and I'll just walk you through my story. I mean, I did instrumentation engineering, flight to Germany, came to Germany to do my master's. I did my master's in Technical University of Munich. So the good thing about doing master's in Germany is we can work part-time. I mean, part-time, not in the sense, not at McDonald's or KFCs. I mean, yes, it is also available, but we can work in an engineering stream in your respective field. So I got into a company called Telefonica, which is O2. And I started my career as a networking engineer. Again, I started with C, C++ and networking stuff. All of a sudden, I got an opportunity to work closely with the data science team. I would say that is the life-changing moment. And when I first started with data science, I was also almost on your side. I was literally zero. I had nothing. I had no basics on statistics or data science. So I was completely lost. So what I did is I did a lot of courses on platforms like Udemy, as HOD sir told, NPTEL helped me a lot during master's days. And the good thing again about universities in Germany is you can pick optional courses. You can take optional courses from the university. Let's say you are doing master's in electronics, you doesn't have to do all the papers in electronics. I mean, of course, there will be some sets of electronics papers that you need to pass, but otherwise there are a lot of data science courses. So I went and took them. I slowly learned Python. I learned R, learned visualization skills, narration skills. I developed slowly. It's not an overnight thing that I'm in front of you. So it took me a lot of time. So as I said, you can always relate this stories and data. So I'm pretty sure that most of you watch movies or Netflix series. I'm a big fan of Money Heist. How many of you are watching online or are a big fan of Money Heist? I'm a big fan of Professor. So he's a rocking guy, right? So I always link stories with data. So in a way, we see a lot of movies, web series. Even there are a lot of Tamil series coming up. I mean not a lot of regional series coming up. I mean, I assume that a lot of people are watching it across India and globe. I mean, I saw a lot of guys joining from Saudi Arabia and Dubai. So yeah, stories from books or movies. It can be funny, it can be memorable, can be powerful sometimes. I mean, some of the inspiring stories can change your life, right? So it can give you ideas, it can be captivating, and some stories are emotional. So yeah, some guy, Raghav Subramanian, has typed in Bella's ear. Thanks a lot. Yeah. Breaking Bad. Yeah, I'm also making it Breaking Bad freak. Yeah. So the point here is connection between stories and data. So as I said, I am a data storyteller. So I visualize things and I narrate things. So in a way, if you want to compare stories and data, those are completely irrelevant. If you look at data, it is completely dry. So let's say a pretty mixie or a Panasonic refrigerator. You need to buy a refrigerator, and all you need is one product. So are you really in need of Panasonic data? I mean, of course you will read some reviews, but at the end of the day, you are not bothered about how many machines that they sold, that they sell every year, how many outcomes turn up good. So data can be completely boring. It is not like a story which is interesting, captivating, and emotional. It is completely vague. So to understand the data, you need to be a little nerdy. And it is also completely impersonal. So let's imagine data sets. The simplest way to imagine a data set is an Excel sheet. So you have, all you have is rows and columns, right? So let's imagine an attendance sheet. So you have the roll numbers, you have the names, you have the class, which section, and present or absent, your presence, and what is your staff faculty, what is your favorite subject. That is data. It is not a rocket science. So don't get carried away by fancy terms and technical jargons. So data sets are simple as that. I mean, if you take an Excel sheet, put a bar graph or a pie chart, then that is the simple data science product or data science application that you have built. So start with Excel. It is not wrong. So if you start with Excel, or if you, let's say, start with a simple pie chart, people might laugh at you. People could laugh at you. Chuck them. Don't worry. You will get better each day. So the key is learning. Learning new things should never stop. So I'll give you a flow. How should a person tell a story with the data? So the first thing is, you understand the context of the data. So for instance, if you look at my personal experience, I did work with telecommunications firm, as I said, and I worked with Volkswagen, which is an automotive. Presently, I work with Siemens, which is again in 150 countries. I mean, I just need to make a pass again to talk about Siemens. I mean, of course, they are my employer. So Siemens is present in 150 plus countries, and they do a lot of stuff. Siemens refrigerators, Siemens washing machines. So it is there in home appliances division. And Siemens is there in energy, grid, power. I myself work with mobility, where we deal with trains. Another real world example that I can tell you is train prediction. So in London, a metro runs for every 2 minutes. So imagine a train is late by a minute or 30 seconds. It will be a chaos for the next coming trains. So we predict real world applications in Siemens. So in order to understand the context, you need some technical know-how. I mean, you simply cannot go from telecommunications to mobility and work right from the day one. So in order to get settled, you need to understand the context, be it Siemens, be it Volkswagen, be it Apple, Google. You need to understand the context first. And then you need to think of an effective visual. That is actually an important step. And then you need to eliminate the clutters. Clutters in the sense, which are all the informations which are not really important to you or the graph. And then you have to have a focus. You have to be attentive. And then you have to tell a story. So that is how you build a story from the data. So you need the technical know-how. You need to choose a proper visual and check out the eliminations, I mean the clutters. And then you have to have a focus and then tell a story. So that is actually important. So let me tell you an example. Let me give you an example story. How many of you have heard of Spotify? Spotify is nothing but a music streaming application. So this is what they'll do at the end of every year. So at the end of every year, end of 2018, 2019, or be it 2020, even when we are struggling with Corona, they come up with this chart. They'll say what are the top artists that you have listened to? What are the top songs that you have listened to? So in a way, they make you indulge in music again. They'll try to grab you again. I mean, if you haven't opened Spotify for a while, this makes you open, right? It is somehow intriguing to you. This is what people will do. And okay, so I know a little bit about data science. I know a little bit about what are the main factors in data science that I should follow and what is data storytelling. Then how should I actually develop myself in data science? So this is what you should be doing during this COVID times. So I have listed a lot of online platforms and trainings here. So for instance, you can always log into Lynda, Udemy, Coursera, edX, NPTEL, as Sir suggested, Udacity. I have listed a lot of platforms here. Start with it. So I'll just again give a pass. If there is any e-learning platform that is available and which I have not posted here, please feel free to type it in the comment section so that the others can learn from you. So in a minute, I'll just have a sip of water. There are a lot of Spotify fans here, it seems. So any e-learning platforms, apart from institutions like RMK and the other institutions. I mean, like I was having a chat with our Honorable Principal Sir, respected Principal Sir. He was telling me that they are having a course on data science. So it was actually surprising to me. I mean, how well the institutions have actually coped up with the industry needs. So they have a course on data science. So apart from learning it from the college hours, what I need is the e-learning platform, because of course you go to college for 8 to 10 hours. I mean, including the travel time, it could be 8 to 10 hours. So you sleep 8 hours and you have the rest of 6 hours plus the weekends, right? I won't push you. It depends on people to people. If you can spare a minute or if you can spare an hour, try these platforms. I personally recommend Lynda, but it is a paid version. Even there is a 1 month free trial. You can make use of it. You can learn some courses. So the idea and the trick I would give for learning courses is log on to LinkedIn, log on to Lynda, log on to Udemy, log on to Coursera. Pick one or two data science course on each platform. Go through the first 5 minutes of each of it. So everybody has their own taste. So for instance, I like guys who deal with practical examples. So that is why you have seen a lot of practical examples, which I gave right from the beginning. So somebody like plain, pretty simple, because I saw someone asking, where is the feedback form? When will the session get over? I'm pretty sure this won't be my sort of liking. So yes, ultimately you cannot satisfy everybody in every aspects of data science. So pick two courses on each platform, learn the first 5 minutes, go through it and see if you kind of sync with it, and then do that particular course and chuck the remaining. Don't spend too much time on certifications, because ultimately that's just a paper. So you cannot do wonders with data science certifications. Okay, that is one thing. And what else you guys can do? Listening to podcasts and webinars like this. So I'm pretty sure that podcast is not actually an Indian thing, but nevertheless, I have listed a couple of podcasts down below. There is a really good O'Reilly data show, Data Stories, Data Science at Home. And the good thing about this is this video is available online. This video will be available on YouTube even after this session. So you can always scroll through. You will not miss any contents of it. So podcast, you can listen to it when you are traveling, right now we are not traveling much, but nevertheless, you can always use it while you are using WhatsApp. You can also do that. I mean, it's all about the evolution, right? So every day, the more you hear about it, the better it will be for you. And then for those who are traditional, for sure, you can read a lot of books and blogs. That is for sure. You can always do that. And I'm a big fan of e-learning. So I do it in a blog way or e-learning way. And if you want quality data science content, you can also follow me on LinkedIn. And as Gnanasekar and Sarah already told, I have maxed out on LinkedIn. So you can just follow me there. I'm not sure if I can accept your request, because 30,000 is the limit that LinkedIn has set, unfortunately. So if you want to still follow my post, please follow me on LinkedIn. So that you can do. I'm not a book guy, so please don't ask me what are the data science books that I should follow. Okay, and make use of this pandemic times. I mean, master a new technology, as I suggested. Learn Python, learn something new. It cannot be data science. I mean, I'm not asking all of you to jump into data science. Maybe you can have a look. You can see what is data science, what is the new concepts, new technologies. AI, artificial intelligence and machine learning is actually really interesting. So please try to learn something new during this pandemic. I heard that the class 10 exams were canceled in Tamil Nadu, so people were going crazy. So even if you are an engineering student and if Anna University is planning to scrap off your exam, try to learn something new. It's always good to learn something. And as I said at the beginning, learning every single day is actually important. And please make use of this pandemic times. Okay, so when it comes to opportunities, what are all the opportunities in data science? So there is data analyst, there is data scientist, there is data engineers, data visualization expert. So there are a lot of opportunities out there. So a lot of people asked me before that, will there be opportunities even after pandemic? For sure it will be, because as you see, it is in every field. Will Facebook just go away after the pandemic? Will Twitter go away after the pandemic? Certainly not. So applications starting from Uber, Ola, Facebook, Netflix, Instagram, everybody are using data science behind their application. So it will not go away for sure. And for people who have lost jobs or trying for new jobs, please upskill yourself during this pandemic, because once the pandemic is over, everybody, every industry will go crazy and you will get a lot of opportunities. So be prepared. And yeah, I guess that's all I have about data science. And we can have a small Q&A session if there is any at the end. Thanks a lot. And thank you, BitCrunch, for providing me this template. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, guys. I hope it is informative. It is still present. I'm still here. So if you want to have any questions at the end, you can always. So I'll go through your code. So maybe the team can pin my video to the screen so that people will be getting a feel of the talking, because I have been showing slides from the beginning. So it's better if you pin my screen to the YouTube. And I'll answer some of the questions. So there is a question: explain data science related project, from Vinod Rajkumar. Yeah, as I said, depends. Real world railway tracking, prediction of trains, prediction of train component failures. And what about data camp? Yeah, you can attend data camps, but make sure it is a legally authorized organization. So that is actually important. And what else? Just a second. I'm just going through the comment section. Thanks a lot. There are a lot of wishes coming for the session. In Python, which module or which library should I do? Manju, it depends. It depends on applications. I mean, there is Matplotlib, there is Seaborn, there's a lot. So it depends on the context of what you need. So that is actually important. Thanks a lot, HOD, ECE. Thanks a lot, because he has personally thanked the HOD of E&I on YouTube for organizing this session. Thanks a lot. Mani Gandan is asking about any best certification for data science. In my opinion, there is not any best data science certification. So in a way, there are certifications, as I said, on the platforms, but it's all about what you have here. So Yusuf, you can always watch the slides here. Thanks a lot. And feedback link, I guess after the session, Sarah will explain about the feedback form in a couple of minutes. So there's a question from Shankaran. What if all the engineers learn data science? What if all learn data science or engineering? It's the same. So it's not about how many people learn data science. It's about how we learn, how you learn data science. So there are a lot of engineers across India, across the globe. So it's not about, okay, there are so many competition in engineering. Should I choose other stream? It's not at all like that. So even as an instrumentation engineer, if I can excel in data science from nowhere, then you can do it. It's all about the confidence that you should have. Don't get scared about the external factors. And Vicky, thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, Srivi. Thanks a lot, Amit Kumar. Thanks a lot, Mohammed Imtiaz. Thank you. So yeah, Julia language, will it replace Python and R? Raghav Subramanian, at the moment, I will say Python has a bigger community, bigger learning community. So that replacing Python will take time. I cannot answer now. But yeah. So what would be the way, ideal way? Learn certifications online. Look for internships. Internships, even if it is unpaid, go for it. approach each incubator like the one we have in RMK Engineering. Approach your staff, faculty members. They'll help you out. And what else? So if you have any other questions, you can always write me on LinkedIn.
Vijay, there are a lot of questions on the Q&A section. If it is already answered, you just remove that, or otherwise you...
Okay. So I have talked about R, Tableau and Python that is done. Prediction of COVID cases that we talked about. Prediction of COVID cases is an example. Arogya Setu app is an example. LinkedIn chat response suggestion, railway shopping site. So these were the examples that we had from the beginning. Yeah, that is good. And why only data science is for big companies? Vijay, that is completely wrong. Data science is everywhere. I see a lot of data science startups booming up. So it is not just for the big companies. Just to make it understandable, I just gave examples from big companies, but there are a lot of data science companies. Even let's take Oyo. Oyo is nowhere. You book a room, right? So they were nowhere a few years back. They use data science. They use algorithms. So it's not about big companies using data science. And yeah, we have responses about the levels of people, how data science will be useful for mechanical engineers. Sankar and Ramesh Babu, mechanical engineers, or be it any engineer, that is what I said. It is applicable in most of the industries. Let's say you are a mechanical engineer, and there are a lot of interesting data science applications that car companies are building it. So let's say Volkswagen, Audi, BMW, they produce a lot of data science products. So with an app or with a navigation system, they do a lot. So it is everywhere. If you study it now, you will be much better. You will be feeling much better. Okay. Coding knowledge, do we need it? Yes, to an extent. But yeah, there are non-programmers option as well. RapidMiner and NIME, Ravik Mohan has used it. Thanks a lot. Nanda Kumar is a big fan of Money Heist. Cheers, Nanda. Thanks a lot. What about Data Camp? Coursera, thanks for the suggestion, Kavita. DevOps versus data science. I'm not too much into data DevOps, but yeah, it is. Is ML knowledge required to be a data scientist? ML is something that comes next. Data science, machine learning, and artificial intelligence are the next versions of it. So you don't have to have the ML knowledge. Accuracy of prediction depends on what? Deekshita, it's actually a generic question, because firstly, it depends on the data sets that you have, and the amount of data you have, and what you want to achieve. So accuracy depends on several factors. You cannot simply generalize it. And what else? What is the biggest data sets that you have processed, and how did you process it? There are a lot. So yeah, the rest of the things I've pretty much answered, sir. So I guess that's it from my side. Will learning on data camp be effective? Learning anywhere is effective. First thing is, you need to learn. Learn it by heart. As I said, learn it by heart, and not just for paper or certification. And I have noticed a lot of people looking out for certifications. This is actually not a proper attitude, I would say. So go for skill development, upskill yourself, and then you can always think about upskilling and getting certifications. Yeah. And yeah, forgot to mention Kaggle. Somebody type in Kaggle on the YouTube video so that people we'll get an idea about what data science is there. There are a lot of data sets available, and you can always notice data sets there. Yeah. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, Principal sir and the HOD sir. It's been a pleasure again. Yeah.
Yeah, one of participant name Akshay Kumar asked one question. It is not technical, but you find it is very useful. If you are not a book guy, then how 9.1 is possible, sir?
Sir was muted. HOD sir, you were muted at the end.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, off late, Akshay, thanks a lot for bringing it up. Off late, I have become an e-learner. I use e-learning platforms now in the past decade. But yeah, to be honest, I was a bookie at the beginning. Yeah. Everybody needs to be a bookie. I mean, bookie in the sense book guys. So yeah, at the beginning, it even I was on your shoes. I had wonderful professors at college days. So I had to learn a lot of stuff by book. So that's how I ended up getting 9.1. during my BE. So yeah, it happens. But yeah, off late, I've started learning a lot on e-learning platform. And I also request the principal, sir, to have a word on the data science course he was talking about, because people are not aware, it seems. I see a lot of texts on YouTube chat as well regarding the course that you are planning to have in the next year.
So yes, sir. BTech Artificial Intelligence and Data Science.
Okay, perfect.
Yes, sir. Yeah. That is a new course. So we have to get approval from Anna University and also AICTE.
Okay.
So within a couple of days, weeks, so definitely we will get. And because already it has been approved by Anna University. Syllabus, okay. In collaboration with industries, we have framed. They have given to an industry board of studies, and they have also approved. We take artificial intelligence and data science.
Okay, okay.
Some of the colleges, even some new colleges, they have planned to start in
Okay, so you are one among the leaders.
Yes.
Good to know, sir.
They are going to start this course in two of our colleges.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, thanks a lot, and thanks a lot.
Thank you, Vijay. Really, it's a very informative session. So I could able to see around nearly 500, 485. Even 8 sessions, I have seen around 500. Because immediately after the session, during our past webinars, so all the participants so started leaving the chat, you know, because they would like to get the certificate after clearing their doubts. They may have some other works and all to take care. So now it is 2:507. Oh, it has crossed 507.
So people are not planning to leave.
Yes. Okay. Really, it's a very informative session. So thank you very much. So please visit our campus during your visit.
For sure. I mean, now you have the course. So it makes my job.
Please, definitely. Our board also. Okay, we have advisory board for each and every course. So definitely of management, sir. Thank you, Vijay. Thank you, sir, HOD sir, for organizing such a great event. Thank you, all the faculty members and technical persons.
Thank you, sir. Yeah, thanks a lot. Nandri, vanakkam.
Vanakkam. Now it's the time to propose vote of thanks, I think. Correct, sir?
Yeah.
Our professor.
Oh, it's 5:28, sir. Plus, I think in Zoom around 56 or nearly 600 participants.
Yeah. Thanks a lot. ரொம்ப சந்தோஷம்
விஜய் இந்த பர்சனல் நோட் திஸ் இஸ் த செஷன் ஐ ஹவ் சீன் லாட் ஆஃப் இன்ட்ரெஷன் நார்மலி இது வெபினார் செஷன் தி ஸ்பீக்கர் வில் ஸ்பீக் த லிசனர் வில் ஓன்லி பேசிவ்லி லிசன் பட் யூ மேட் தி ஆல் த பார்ட்டிசிபென்ட்ஸ் வெரி இன்ட்ராக்டிவ் அண்ட் தேங்க்ஸ் ஃபார் தட் அவர் ப்ரொஃபஸர் டாக்டர் விஜயலட்சுமி மேடம் இஸ் வெயிட்டிங் டு ப்ரொபோஸ் வாட் ஆர் தேங்க்ஸ் மேடம் ப்ளீஸ் மேடம்
Good evening, one and all present for this webinar on Insights of Data Science for Engineers. I hope you all have enjoyed the informative session from our TEDx speaker, Mr. Vijay Praveen. Dear all, no duty is more urgent than that of returning thanks. I'm Dr. S. Vijayalakshmi, Professor in Electronics and Instrumentation Engineering Department. So much delighted and privileged to be in front of you for presenting the vote of thanks. First of all, I could like to propose hearty vote of thanks to our chief guest, Mr. Vijay Praveen, Customer and Analytics Solution Expert, Siemens Germany, for gracing today's webinar. Dear participants, we along with you are really gifted to hear this provoking speech from an experienced data scientist with a passion for tuning raw data into products, actionable insights, meaningful stories, developing next generation analytical techniques. Thank you, sir, for your excellent and provoking presentations. Your speech was really interesting and inspiring. Once again, thank you, sir, for spending your valuable time with us. I could like to express our profound gratitude to our beloved Chairman, sir, Vice Chairman, sir, Director, sir, and members of management for encouraging us to organize this kind of webinar to the society so as to transform the knowledge from the experts to the members of the society. I express my sincere gratitude to our principal, sir, for his continuous motivation and support. My sincere thanks to our advisor, sir, Dean Academics, Dean Research, for their support and guidance. Special thanks to our head of the department, Dr. Nanasekaran, sir, for his tireless effort and guidance. I must mention our deep sense of appreciation to all our faculty members of Electronics and Instrumentation Engineering Department in making this event to reach various parts of the globe and for making this webinar a great success. My dear faculty members, today more than 500 participants are watching this webinar because of the tireless effort of the technical team members, Mr. Bharat Singh and Mr. Ardhanarishwaran. Dear participants, the success of the webinar could not have happened without your enrollment. On behalf of RMK Engineering College, we wish to acknowledge our sincere thanks for your enthusiastic participation. Thank you all for the opportunity given to me.
Thank you. We'll meet again.
Yeah, we'll meet again, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Take care. Stay safe.